Qatar sport is one of the strategy that the country have decided to go through, because through sport you can get so many exposure to the outside world. And if you can see that 4 years ago only we have about 4 to 5 international competition, but now we have about 15 to 20 state-of-the-art competition. We can say that we have a lot of network going through this to have a good knowledge with other nations to be involved or coming to Qatar. We have a theory in Qatar, a triangle theory. The first one is economy. The second one is education. The third one from the triangle is a sport. Because if you set up this triangle in any country, you will be succeed. Means it's not only taking care of the population or the people of Qatar in terms of economy, but you are also doing a great job in education, and that's what in Qatar has been done. Also, in addition to this, you are providing the population or the people of Qatar of the best sport event, and also you are providing them with the best facility and best venue. Since 3 years ago, we have set up a committee called the National Team Caring Committee. This committee is in charge of developing the national team players, the talent player, the top of the, or the best from each federation. We have provided them with the best training location in the world. They can go and do their training. We are going to host the Asian Games, but people of Qatar will not be only happy if you are hosting the Asian Games, even if you host the best Asian Games, because in the end of the day, also you have to win the medals.
I think the initiatives of the Qatari National Olympic Committee are really very good. Qatar cannot thrive on a very big population, so they have definitely to find value through innovative ideas, and they do it by organizing major competitions and at the same time attracting very big events like the Asian Games.
In December 2006, we will have the Asian Games. It is the first time will be held in one of the Arabic nations in the Gulf region, and also second time to be held in West Asia.
I think you never achieve something by accident. All successes are preceded by hard work, dedication, and definitely in voting for Doha for the Asian Games, the Asian National Olympic Committee trusted the quality of the National Olympic Committee led by Sheikh Tamim.
When you have such kind of event, you are not only testing the National Olympic Committee or the organizing committee, but you are testing the whole country, because you have to provide the best facility of venue and also of accommodation, of communication, of transportation. You have to have the best highway. All this, you can finish it because you have a deadline and you have to meet this deadline.
The example of Qatar and National Olympic Committee cannot be translated to all the National Olympic Committees in the world, because not all of them have the same wealth and resources. But definitely, rather than being, you know, a rank and file National Olympic Committee, they have chosen to have an added value, and that is something very important.
Nothing else can be done for the country to bring it 20 years ahead of it is what is now, other than having a big event such as the Asian Games. And that is what most of the country are fighting to have.
If you have the means, I think that spending money on sport is the best investment you can do.
We never know what will be after that, but we are building the bases, making Qatar capable of holding any international competition.
Well, I would like definitely to wish Sheikh Tamim the very best for 2006. It is a major challenge, but I'm quite sure that knowing his quality and the quality of his team, that it's going to be a major success.